Now, in the previous video, I talked about the ways you can improve your CRS score. I talked extensively on the first one, but I didn't talk about the second. And I wanted to make it the second step that you could also use while you are working on your Canadian immigration for Express Entry, through the Express Entry program. Now, the job offer that I said earlier in the previous video, you could use it to actually obtain over 600 points for your CRS scores, and you having that, you don't really need to actually go for another testing for IELTS or TEF Canada examinations. Likewise, you don't even need to do additional master's degree, you understand, to get evaluated and add up to your CRS score. But this next step that I want to talk about, you could also use it to get that same 600 points. And now imagine you get a job offer which gives you 600 points, and you get this other opportunity which gives you 600 points, 1200 CRS scores, for just a kind of cutoff of maybe 280, as we are, I mean 380 or maybe 400 or things like that. You know that you have gone beyond even the criteria, so definitely you are going to be selected for immigration to Canada. Now, this next step is where you actually contact provinces and territories in Canada for provincial nomination opportunities. Now, just as we in Nigeria, for instance, makes use of states like Kaduna, Kwara, Lagos, and things like that, they don't make use of states, rather they make use of territories and provinces. Now, in those places, just like as you can agree with me, the kind of jobs you may need in Lagos may be quite different from the kind of jobs you need in Ilorin. Take for instance in the transportation sector, whereby we have taxi men here, which are quite much or more than people that are in Lagos, where we have the downfalls and things like that, just to highlight the kind of differences. So the kind of jobs people do in Lagos may be quite different, not totally different, but still quite different from the kind of jobs they need in Kwara. So as a result of that, if you want to migrate to maybe places like Alberta, you may be required to do a certain job which is quite different from places like Ontario and what they actually require. So as a result of that, provinces always have nominee programs they will use to check people on the Express Entry pool and see the kind of jobs that they need, the kind of people that they need, the expertise they need to actually improve their own territory, their own provinces, and get to select you based on their. So you may, sometimes we have seen situations whereby people don't have high CRS scores, but because the province that requires their expertise see that they need them, they are going to give them nominations. And how are you going to get that opportunity is for you to actually go through, apart from you just creating a profile on Express Entry, you must also go through, especially if you can afford it, you could go through the nomination programs by checking the provinces, the websites of each provinces and territories, see their criteria for people that want to come over there, look at their jobs, you understand, they are actually the people they are seeking for, the personnel they are seeking for, and if you are very, very much required, or you have the criteria that can make you actually move to those provinces, you can as well get to apply for their nomination programs in conjunction with the Express Entry. And the beauty of this, for a lot of people want to work in the capital area, the capital city of Canada, like Ontario, like Toronto, a lot of people want to work there, but you can first of all go through maybe Alberta, you could go through New Brunswick, you could go through Nova Scotia, you understand, and places like that. Once you go through them, within a year or two, you understand, you can now move to the capital city if you so wish, after actually living there for some time. So you could just, the main thing is get to Canada. When you get to Canada through the provincial nomination, you can now move once you are okay, once you are settled in Canada. So if you have any questions, you could go on cic.gc.ca to check the different provinces and the different nominations. You will always see their provinces, and you'll be able to go to their website. They have separate websites for the nominee programs. So you could go to their website, check their criteria up, and also apply to anyone that best suits your purpose. So thank you very much, and I do hope to see you in the next video.